ॐ नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं उदीरये। नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवते उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम सिक्स्थ कांटो चैप्टर 11 ए ट्रांसडेंटल क्वालिटीज ऑफ वृत्रासुर टेक्स्ट 5। यदि वह प्रधाने श्रद्धा सारं वा क्षुल्लका हृदि अग्रे तिष्ठत मात्रं मे न चेत् ग्राम्य सुखे स्पृहा। यदि वह प्रधाने श्रद्धा सारं वा क्षुल्लका हृदि अग्रे तिष्ठत मात्रं मे न चेद् ग्राम्य सुखे स्पृहा। यदि वह प्रधाने श्रद्धा सारं वा क्षुल्लका हृदि अग्रे तिष्ठत मात्रं मे न चेद् ग्राम्य सुखे स्पृहा। यदि वह प्रधाने श्रद्धा सारं वा क्षुल्लका हृदि अग्रे तिष्ठत मात्रं मे न चेत् ग्राम्य सुखे स्पृहा। यदि वह प्रधाने श्रद्धा सारं वा क्षुल्लका हृदि अग्रे तिष्ठतः मात्रं मे सारं वा क्षुल्लका हृदि अग्रे तिष्ठत मात्रं मे न चेत् ग्राम्य सुखे स्पृहा। ब्रह्मे अचेदाम्य सुखे स्पृहा वार्ड मीनिंग यदि इफ वह अप यू प्रधाने इन बैटल श्रद्धा फेथ सारम पेशेंस बा और क्षुल्लका वो इनसिग्निफिकेंट वांस हृदय इन द कोर ऑफ द हार्ट अग्रे इन फ्रंट तिष्ठत जस्ट स्टैंड मात्रम फॉर ए मोमेंट मे ऑफ मी न नट चेत इफ ग्राम्य सुखे इन सेंस ग्रैटिफिकेशन स्पृहा डिजायर ट्रांसलेशन एंड पार्पोर्ट बाई डिवाइन ग्रेस अभय चरण अरविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय. ट्रांसलेशन ओ इनसिग्निफिकेंट डेमिगड्स इफ यू ट्रूली हैव फेथ इन योर हीरोइज्म इफ यू हैव पेशेंस इन द कोर्स ऑफ योर हार्ट्स एंड इफ यू आर नॉट एम्बिशियस फॉर सेंस ग्रैटिफिकेशन प्लीज स्टैंड बिफोर मी फॉर ए मोमेंट. प्लीज रिपीट. ओ इनसिग्निफिकेंट डेमिगड्स इफ यू ट्रूली हैव फेथ इन योर हीरोइज्म इफ यू हैव पेशेंस इन द कोर ऑफ योर हार्ट्स एंड इफ यू आर नॉट एम्बिशियस फॉर सेंस ग्रैटिफिकेशन प्लीज स्टैंड बिफोर मी फॉर ए मोमेंट. पार्पोट रिबीक्यूइंग द डेमिगड्स वृत्रासुर चैलेंज्ड ओ डेमिगड्स इफ यू आर एक्चुअली हीरोज स्टैंड बिफोर मी नाउ एंड ट्राई टू शो योर प्रोवेस इफ यू डू नॉट विश टू फाइट इफ यू आर एफ्रेड ऑफ लूजिंग योर लाइव्स आई शैल नॉट किल यू फॉर अनलाइक यू आई एम नॉट सो इविल माइंडेड एज टू किल पर्सन्स हु आर नाइदर हीरोइक नॉर विलिंग टू फाइट इफ यू हैव फेथ इन योर हीरोइज्म प्लीज स्टैंड बिफोर मी. हरे कृष्ण. ओम अज्ञानातिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरुभे नमः. श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं जनभूतले स्वयं रूपः कदामहं ददाति सोपदान्तिकं. वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरुः श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथानितं तं सजीवं सावद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपदान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखानितांश्च. नमो ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने. नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषः शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे. नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनामिने गौरतिशे नमः. हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकांत राधाकांत नमस्तुते. तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विश्वभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये. वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च ಕೃಪಾಸಿಂಧೂಭ್ಯೇವ ಚ ಪತಿತಾನಾಂ ಪಾವನೇಭ್ಯೋ ವೈಷ್ಣವೇಭ್ಯೋ ನಮೋ ನಮಃ. ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಪ್ರಭು ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಶ್ರೀ ಅದ್ವೈತ ಗದಾಧರ ಶಿವಾಸಾದಿ ಗೌರಭಕ್ತವೃಂದ. ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಹರೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ, ಹರೇ ರಾಮ 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 ಹರೇ ಹರೇ. ಜದಿಬಹ ಪ್ರಧಾನೆ ಶ್ರದ್ಧಾ ಸಾರಂಭ ಕ್ಷುಲ್ಲಕ ಹೃದಿ ಅಗ್ರೆ ತಿಷ್ಠತ ಮಾತ್ರಂ ಮೇ ನಚೇತ್ ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಯ ಸುಖೇ ಸ್ಪೃಹ. ಓ ಇನ್ಸಿಗ್ನಿಫಿಕೆಂಟ್ ಡೆಮಿಗಡ್ಸ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟ್ರೂಲಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫೇತ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹೀರೋಯಿಸಮ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಕೋರ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಂಬಿಷಿಯಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಗ್ರಾಟಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಮೀ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಭಾರ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಪೋಕನ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಹೀರೋಯಿಕ್ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ ಆರ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಡಿಮನ್, ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಡಿವೋಟಿ. ಈ ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡಿಮನ್, ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಡಿವೋಟಿ. ಹೂ? ರುದ್ರಾಸುರ. ಇನ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರಿವಿಯಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಮಹಾರಾಜ್ ಚಿತ್ರಕೇತು. ಜನರಲಿ ಡಿಮನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿವೋಟೀಸ್. ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಡೆಮನ್ ಡಿಮನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೋಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನೋ ಫೇತ್ ಆನ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು. ಡಿಮನ್ಸ್ ನೆವರ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇವತಾ ಡೆಮಿಗಾಡ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಶೆಲ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ವೃತ್ರಾಸುರ ದೋ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಡಿಮನಿಯಾಕ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಡಿಮನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೀಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿ ಕಮಾಂಡರ್ ಇನ್ ಚೀಫ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಮಿ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಮನ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಹಿ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ. ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿಸೋಬೆಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ. ಜನರಲಿ ದಿ ಡಿಮನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಫಾಲೋ ದಿ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಸಿ ವೃತ್ರಾಸುರ ದೋ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಡಿಮನ್ ಬಟ್ ಹೀ ಈಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಡಿವೋಟಿ. ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಫುಲ್ ಫೇತ್ ಆನ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು. ಇವನ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಶಿವ ಹಿ ಸ್ಪೋಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಭಾರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಗ್ಲೋರಿಫೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಮಹಾರಾಜ್ ಚಿತ್ರಕೇತು ಹೂ ಎನ್ ಹಿ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಎ ಡೆಮನಿಯಾಕ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸಿಸ್. ನಾರಾಯಣ ಪರಾಸರ್ವೇ ನ ಬಿಭ್ಯಶ್ಚತಿ ಕಶ್ಚನ ಸ್ವರ್ಗ ಅಪವರ್ಗ ನರಕೇಶು ಅಪಿ ತುಲ್ಯಾರ್ಥದರ್ಶಿನ. ಎ ಡಿವೋಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು ಆರ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಹಿ ನೆವರ್ ಫಿಯರ್ ಫಾರ್ ವೆದರ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ಹೆಲಿಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾನೆಟ್ ಆರ್ ಹಿ ಈಸ್ ಅವಾರ್ಡೆಡ್ ಹೆವೆನ್ಲಿ ಪ್ಲಾನೆಟ್ ಆರ್ ಹಿ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಅಟೆಂಡ್ ದಿ ಲಿಬರೇಷನ್ ವೆನ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಎ ಡಿವೋಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು ಆರ್ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಹಿ ಈಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಮೇ ನಾಟ್ ಫರ್ಗೆಟ್ ದಿ ಸುಪ್ರೀಂ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ನಾರಾಯಣ. ಹಿ ಮೇ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಟೈಮ್ ದಿ ಗ್ಲೋರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ನಾರಾಯಣ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದೋ ವೃತ್ರಾಸುರ ವಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಡಿಮನಿಯಾಕ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸಿಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ಡಿಮನ್. ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಶ್ರೀ ಗೌರ್ನಿತಾಯ ಕಿ ಜಯ, ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಬಲರಾಮ್ ಕಿ ಜಯ, ರಾಧಾ ಶ್ಯಾಮ ಸುಂದರ್ ಕಿ ಜಯ. ದೋ ವೃತ್ರಾಸುರ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ಔಟ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ಲಿ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಡಿಮನ್ ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ಲಿ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಬೆಟರ್ ಡಿವೋಟಿ ದೆನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟಿಟರ್ ದಿ ಡೆಮಿಗಡ್ಸ್ ಇವಿನ್ ದಿ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೆವೆನ್ ಇಂದ್ರ. ಇಂದ್ರ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಡಿವೋಟಿ ಲೈಕ್ ವೃತ್ರಾಸುರ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಂದ್ರ ವಾಸ್ ಸಕಾಮ ಭಕ್ತ. ಹಿ ಹಸ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಸೈರ್ಸ್. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಈಸ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೆವೆನ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂದ್ರಸ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್. ಹಿ ನೆವರ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಲೂಸ್ ದಟ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್. ಬಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವೃತ್ರಾಸುರ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎನಿ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಡೆಸಿಗ್ನೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎನಿ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಫಾರ್ ಎನಿ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಪವರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೇಮ್ ಫೇಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಡೋರೇಷನ್ಸ್. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಡಿವೋಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಟಲ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೀಸ್ ಅಪೋನೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಡೆಮಿಗಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಡಿಮನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ವೃತ್ರಾಸುರ. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಡಿಫೀಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಿ ಡೆಮಿಗಡ್ಸ್. ಡೆಮಿಗಡ್ಸ್ ಡಿಫೀಟೆಡ್ ದೆಮ್. ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಡಿಮನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫೀಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ದಿ ಡೆಮಿಗಡ್ ನೆಸರಿ ದಿ ಡಿಮನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಅವೇ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಟಲ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಯರ್. to protect themselves out of fear of death. They are just running. And from the rear or from the back side, the demigods are killing the demons. But that is not the rule in a battlefield. If someone just running away from the battlefield out of fear of death, or if someone surrendered, just puts his hands up, I am surrendered, then the opponents who is fighting with him should not kill him. That is the rule of war in the history, like Mahabharata or so many wars in India history. So he is not supposed to be killed. But here, even the demigods, they know all the Shastric injunctions, all the rules and regulations in battlefield. But still, they were killing the demons, those who are running out of fear of their death. That's why Putrasura is addressing the demigods, telling you are such coward peoples. You are called demigods, the great devotee of Lord Vishnu. But still, you are not following the rules in the battlefield. For a Kshatriya, one who considers himself a hero should not kill an enemy who is afraid of losing his life. Such killing is never glorious, nor can it promote one to heavenly planets. One should not kill such person. Nor a person who is in battlefield should run away from battlefield. He is also chastising, on the other hand, the demons also. What type of people you are? Why you are running away from battlefield? Just like in Gita we see Krishna advised to Arjuna, hatova prapsyasi swargam jitva va bhokyase mahim tasmad utishtha kaunteya yudhyaya krita nischaya. Krishna is telling in Kshatriya, in battlefield, hatova prapsyasi swargam. If a person in battlefield fighting with his opponents, even he get killed in the battlefield, then he will achieve heavenly planet. He will get higher species. From human species or from demoniac species, he may attain the heavenly planet where he become a demigod. And if he won the battle, or if he will win the battle, then he will be the king of or ruler of the entire earthly planet. So what is wrong? So that's why in a Kshatriya in a battlefield, he should not run away from the battlefield. Because the qualities of a Kshatriya that Krishna is mentioning in Bhagavad Gita, 18th chapter, it is like verse 43, that Saurjyam, Tejo, Dhruti, Dakhya, Yudhye, Chapya, Apalayanam, Dana, Ishwara, Bhavascha, Khyatram, Karma, Svabhajam. A Kshatriya king, or a Kshatriya person in Kshatriya clan, or if he is considered himself as Kshatriya, then he must possess all these qualities. A Kshatriya is not by birth, or a Brahman is not simply by birth. He must also possess the qualities of a Brahman and Kshatriya. So, this one of the qualities of Kshatriya is Yudhye Apalayanam. He should not run away from the battle. Do or die. That is Kshatriya principle. Either he defeat his enemy, kill the enemy, or himself maybe get killed. Kshatriya never run away from battlefield. Because he knows if he will get killed in battlefield, then he will attain heavenly planet. What is wrong? If he will win the battle, then he will, the ruler of the this planet, or the ruler of that particular kingdom. So that's why Dhritarashtra was very disturbed, seeing that one way the demons are running away from the battle in fear of their life, to protect their life. They are just running away to protect their body. And the other hand, those who are running away from the battle out of fear of their life, and these demons are cowardly, they are just killing them from they are attacking them in the backside, from rear, and killing them, just like killing animals. So that's why Dhritarashtra is very furious. He is seeing that both are not following the rules of battle, neither demigods nor the demons. One should not run away from battlefield, but the demons are running away from battlefield. And when someone is running away out of fear of his life, so the people, the other opponents, they should not attack them from rear, from the backside. They should only kill them. but demigods are killing them. So that's why now Dhritarashtra is challenging, just standing in the middle when the demigods are just running away, up, running after the demons. Just in between came, who came? Dhritarashtra. Huge, gigantic body, huge body. He just expand his body and stand in the middle. Then he's speaking to the demigods, challenging the demigods. Jadiva Pradhana Shraddha, if you have real faith in battle, Pradhana means battle. If you have real faith in battle, if you are real hero, you are coming to fight with the demons and you are heroes, so you are in battlefield. Then Jadiva Pradhana, Pradhana means any battlefield, in battle, or Shraddha, if you have faith in your heroism, as a great hero or fighter, then you must have patience, saram, you must have patience. And actually for me you are very insignificant fellows, I don't care all of you. You all demigods may be one side and I am alone is sufficient to fight all with all of you. If you have really you are heroes, then be patient. Khullaka, insignificant ones. If you are really heroes, then stand before me. Come in front of me. Just run after this, those who are fearful, those who are running away to protect their lives. Come in front of me. I am challenging you, all the demigods. Just stand in front of me. It is such a heroic statement. If you have some desire for sense gratification, you may not face my challenge. Otherwise, if you are real hero, real Kshatriyas, you must face my challenge. A Kshatriya cannot, when someone asks someone for asking for fighting, a Kshatriya cannot refuse. He will come immediately to fight. That is their nature. Even we see in Mahabharata war, sides of Kauravas, in Duryodhana's side, everyone was killed. Only Duryodhana was left in end. And he was hiding in where? In Manasarovar lake, sitting in the lap of Lakshmi Devi. He was a devotee of Lakshmi. Who? Duryodhana. Duryodhana was a devotee of Lakshmi. He was not worshipping Narayana, but he was worshipped in previous life to Lakshmi. Lakshmi was very pleased with him. That's why Duryodhana, if he will give something, then he was such a glorious hand. If he will give some charity, then his treasury will not empty. It will increase twice, double. That's why when Maharaj Yudhishthira was performing Rajasuya Yajna, then Lord Sri Krishna advised, keep godown keeper and the treasurer to Duryodhana. But Duryodhana was trying his best to finish all the resources in Pandava side. They may not give the properly the charity to other saintly persons and demigods, then their yajna may not be successful. But he did not know the secret that why Krishna told him to make to remain as their treasurer. Because when Duryodhana gave something, then again this treasury will fill again twice more. So he was a devotee of Lakshmi, he was very favorable by Lakshmi. So when in the end Duryodhana was about to be killed, Lakshmi herself personally took him, just sit in my lap. As long as you are, I am my shelter, no one could kill you. So in Manasarovar lake, Lakshmi was sitting in a lotus, their lotus garden, and within the lotus garden she was sitting on lap of Lakshmi. Protecting Lakshmi, was protecting Duryodhana. He was considered Duryodhana as if her son. But when Krishna knows the secret, where is Duryodhana? Then he just told Bhim, go and shout, challenge Duryodhana. You are a coward, you are such a, tell very bad words to Duryodhana. A Kshatriya cannot tolerate the challenge. Someone challenge him for fighting, he cannot remain calm and quiet. Duryodhana just put Lakshmi away and run away with his club to fight with Bhima. He knows that I am going to be killed, but still come to fight. That is Kshatriya spirit. That's why Rudrasura is telling you cowardly demigods, you are just killing the innocent people, those who are running away from the battlefield for protection of, for the fearful situation to protect their own life. If you are real hero, I am challenging all of you. Come in front of me. Stand in front of me. If you are not any desire for sense gratification, a real hero, then stand in front of me. I am ready to fight of you. Alone, I am ready to fight all of you together, all the demigods. So that is the statement here. In making the heroic statement. Saramba khullaka hrudi, you are khullaka, you are very insignificant before me. For me, you are very insignificant demigods. If you are within your heart, agre tishtatam, please stand in front of me with patience. If you don't have any gramya sukhe spruha, gramya sukhe spruha means desire for sense gratification. If you have no desire for sense gratification, then just stand in front of me. Try your best to fight with me. I am challenging you. Why you are simply running after the cowardly demons, just running away from battlefield? But I am alone is enough to challenge all of you. I am challenging. Then Rudrasura make a huge sound. Simply hearing his sound, all the demigods fainted. They sort of fell down. Just like a thunderbolt strike to their heart. Then next verse we'll see how he shout Rudrasura. It was huge. Even Salo, even Indra with his elephant, everyone Salo inside. Again, allow them to come outside. He was a great hero. Who? Rudrasura. Though he was in demoniac species, but still he never disobeyed the instructions or injections of Shastra as a Kshatriya, fight in the battlefield. So that's why Prabhupada is writing that Rudrasura is rebuking the demigods. He challenged, "O demigods, if you are actually heroes, stand before me now and try to show your prowess. If you do not wish to fight, if you are afraid of losing your lives, then I shall not kill you." Like you are killing these people, the demons, they are fear of their life, losing their life, so they are not ready to fight with all of you. They are just running out of battlefield, out of fear, but still you are killing them from backside, from rear. But if you are afraid of losing your lives, I shall not kill you. I am not like you. For unlike you, I am not so evil-minded as to kill persons who are neither heroic nor willing to fight. If you have faith in your heroism, please stand before me. A real hero in a fighting, he only fight a person who is equally matched with him to fight. If his opponent is a coward person, a hero did not want to fight with him. How Bhishmadev was killed? Because one person came to challenge him. Who? Shikhandi. Shikhandi was not a warrior, proper warrior. He was not a match with Bhishmadev in fighting. Bhishmadev saw this person is a cowardly person. He is not a hero. He is not equal with me in fighting. Bhishmadev kept his weapon down. He did not want to fight with Shikhandi. And seeing this situation, Krishna just advised Arjuna to just throw his arrows on the body of Bhishmadev. So we see the Bhishmadev was a hero. So he did not want to fight with a person who is not in equal term with him in fighting, Shikhandi. So hero, he fights with a person who is equal to him in front. If someone in battlefield has no weapon in his hand, then also the opponent should not kill him. He should allow him to have first a weapon, and in fighting he should kill him. When he's fighting with him, then he has right to kill him. So that is the Kshatriya rule. But here even the demigods, they are not following the Kshatriya rules, then who will follow? generally demons they don't follow. Somehow other they want to be win the battle by hook or crook by some. But demigods, they generally follow the rules and regulations in the battlefield according to Shastric injections. But here is his difference. Demigods just killing the demons who are even not a mood to fight in battlefield, out of fear, in order to protect their own life, they are just running away from the battlefield, but still they are killing. So that's why Rudrasura is challenging demigods. If you are a real hero, come in front of me. Then we will discuss the other things in forthcoming verses, how it is very difficult to deal with whom? Rudrasura. Even Indra was confused. Who is this person, whether I shall kill him or not? Because he is speaking all the philosophy of Vaishnava philosophy. He is telling, Indra, you kill me. If you will kill me, then I will return back to Godhead. I want to be killed by you. Because when Rudrasura make a huge sound, by hearing this huge sound, simply the demigods, they fainted all. They fainted in the battlefield. They become unconscious and fainted. Seeing the situation, Indra just tried to throw one of his club towards Rudrasura. So this is enough to kill Rudrasura. Who was thinking? Indra. Rudrasura just playingly, laughingly, he was loudly, he laughed with laughing, and he just cut the club in his left hand and he threw it to his Airavat, the career of Indra. Then the Airavat was just, he could not tolerate this, he was just fell down with Indra on the battlefield. And the blood just coming from his mouth, from the mouth of Airavat, of this elephant, carrier of Indra. But when he saw that they fell down, if a demon, they could immediately kill them or beat them heavily. But Rudrasura did not like that. He just stand there waiting after Indra was standing again, ready to fight with him. He is following all the rules. So you see, even Indra become fearful. How can I fight with this person? I think even if Lord Vishnu's by mercy we get this specific weapon, what? Vajra, the thunderbolt that is made from the bone of the great rishi, great saintly person Dadichi. It is meant to kill Rudrasura. But still Indra get confused whether I just throw this powerful club, he just cut it. So maybe I throw the Vajra and he also just cut it and just break it through it. He was confused. But Rudrasura was again encouraging Indra. Oh hero, don't worry. I am definitely going to kill by you, because Lord Vishnu is in your side. Lord Vishnu, by Vishnu's mercy you get this weapon. But I know only by killing in your hand, I will return back to Godhead. My master Sankarsan or Lord Vishnu, he is waiting for me in the spiritual world. As soon as you kill me, then I will return back to Godhead. So I am encouraging him, please kill me immediately, throw this Vajra, throw this thunderbolt on me. But Indra was confused. What type of person he is fighting with me? He is a devotee or a demon? I don't understand. He was confused. Who? Indra. But Rudrasura was again and again telling him for fighting. So in the forthcoming verses, we'll discuss all these things. So Rudrasura was a great hero and great devotee. Though he was in demoniac species, outwardly he looks like a demon, but inwardly he was a great devotee. So any question or comment? Yes.
Anybody? Gita, Krishna explains two kinds of living entity, divine and demoniac. The difference is divine follows Yakshana Shastra.
Yes, yes.
So, it seems in previous yugas the demons actually did follow Shastra. They would be following, maybe Karmakanda portions and things like this to get their initiates.
Mm.
So, also we understand that subterranean heavenly planets are more opulent than the abode of the devas. The lower planetary systems are inhabited by the demons. So they, in order to achieve that, they're following some form of Vedic injunction. But they're demons. Here it says that the demon does not follow Shastra.
No, not all demons also follow Shastra. Like, there are two Mahajans from demons. Who? Daityanang Prahlada Chasmi. Krishna is telling anyone among the Daityas, the demons, I am Prahlada. And also Bali Maharaj. He is also demons, demoniac species. Born in demoniac family. But still they are great devotees. He is also seeing Dhritarashtra, he is a demon, but he has great devotee. So sometimes there is also great devotees in demoniac. Their number is very, very less considering to demigods. But still there is some devotees in demoniac species. Even Krishna, Lord Vishnu himself protecting. Whom? Bali Maharaj. In Sutala Loka, he is standing as bodyguard. Lord Vishnu himself standing in the front door of Bali Maharaj's kingdom. His palace. So no demigods will attack Bali Maharaj, cannot have the courage to attack Bali Maharaj. Because Lord Vishnu is himself protecting him. Because he surrendered everything, he gave everything to Lord Vishnu. So Vishnu is giving him protection. So sometimes whether someone devotee or demigod, Krishna is actually equal to everyone. Samaham sarvabhuteshu name doshti nachame priya. Ye bhajanti tumang bhaktya, te mai te tesu, te chapi aham. So Krishna is not, but even his demon, even he performed devotional service to Krishna, he also become dear to Krishna. So, but it is in the general cases, the demigods are always surrendered to Krishna. But still they are the sakam bhaktas. Sometimes demigods, they fight with, ready to fight with Krishna. In Govardhan pastimes, how Indra become, he is disturbed. Simply because Krishna told the Vajavasi, don't worship Indra, worship Govardhan. He becomes so, forgot his own sense. Who is he, who is Krishna, he forgot everything. For their power, position, they could not tolerate these things. Even after killing Narakasura, and Narakasura was the Bhumasura, the son of Mother Earth. After killing him, because he became a demon later on. So Krishna, after killing this Bhumasura or Narakasura, then he went to heavenly planet to return the ear ring of Mother Aditi. Then Satyabha made a desire to have one Parijata flower. Then the Indra told, no, cannot take Parijata flower from my garden. This is only for the demigods, not for the... He forgot who is Krishna. So simply these demigods are sometimes also for little disturbance for their sense gratification, they immediately get ready to fight with Krishna. So, but the demons like Prahlad, Bali Maharaj, or Dhritarashtra, even in the demoniac species, they surrender everything to Krishna. Bali Maharaj surrendered, he is Atmanivedan, he is a Mahajan, by surrendering everything to Krishna. Even disobeying the order of his demoniac spiritual master, Shukracharya. So, sometimes there is also demons, so there is devotees also among demons. Yes.
So, you mentioned how the revenge was devoted to Lakshmi. So, I'm wondering how that works out, because usually we pray to worship demigods were obliged to give blessing to Lakshmi is not known by ordinary living beings.
Lakshmi is, there are so many types of Lakshmis. Eh? There is Raja Lakshmi, Lakshmi in this material planet, supplying all the sense gratification things. There is also Lakshmi in heavenly planet, Lakshmi in Vaikuntha planet. There are different categories of Lakshmis. Eh? Duryodhana was a devotee of Lakshmi in the material planet, in this earthly planet, eh? Raja Lakshmi. Okay. Any other question or comment? So what is... Yes. Last question. Family war, just Mahabharata war is a family war, fighting the brothers. Eh? Similarly, the demon and demigods, they are also son of the same father. Who? Kashyapa Muni. Kashyapa Muni, their only wife is different. Aditi, the son of Aditi are Adityas, the demigods. And son of Diti and Diti are called Daityas. And Danu, another wife. Danu and Diti, they are sons. Danavas and Daityas, they are known as demons. Father is the same, only mother is different. They are same family. So, because the Lord Vishnu gave the ruling of heaven to demigods, the son of Adityas. But they want to make the demigods get out from heavenly planets. They want to override the power of demigods that is given by Lord Vishnu himself. That's why, though Bali Maharaj was a great devotee, but he was in demoniac family. So he want to snatch the heavenly kingdom, heavenly throne from Indra. Let's say, Bamandev could not kill his, Vishnu cannot kill his devotee, he is devotee. But still he was want to override his authority. That's why Krishna came as a beggar. Came as a Bamandev. Begging, please give me this arm. I am come. Eh? So he took everything. So, but Bali Maharaj proved that he was not disturbed. He was better devotee than any demigod. Bali Maharaj. That's why he was Mahajan. So even sometimes in demoniac family such devotees. In devatas, in family of the demigods, very rare pure devotees. Who is pure devotee? Only Jamaraj. Jamaraj is a Mahajan, he is pure devotee. Eh? Indra is not a pure devotee, he is a Sakam Bhakta. He is always fearful of just losing his position. He is always ready to fight in exchange of losing his own authority in heavenly planet. Anyone performing some pious activities or some of the yajna sacrifices, then he becomes very fearful. This person may be take a... That took my position. He was stealing the yajna horse of Prithu Maharaj. 99 yajnas he performed, also the yajnas, then 100 yajnas he was again and again coming, somehow or other just stealing the horse. Among the demigods family, though they are worshipper of Lord Vishnu, but only for their own self gratification. To get the sense gratification thing. That's why Dhritarashtra is challenging them. If you have no desire for sense gratification, then come and stand in front of me. In other words, Dhritarashtra is telling, I have no desire for sense gratification. He is fully surrendered to Lord Vishnu, desire. But on the other hand, demigods are standing, though they are externally considered as the devotee of Lord Vishnu, but they are full of material desires. Only for the satisfaction of their senses, they are under the shelter of Vishnu. Sometimes the demoniac family, we saw the devotee become from demoniac family. He he became a very pure devotee like Prahlad or like Bali Maharaj and Vrutrasura. Sridhar Swami is telling, this Purana, how can we recognize Bhagavat Purana? Bhagavat Purana could be recognized in that Purana in which this episode of Vrutrasura is described, not in other Puranas. Bhagavata is describing what is the philosophy of Vaishnavas. Eh? Vaishnavas never think to achieve heavenly planet or hellish planet or the liberation. He is only desirous to satisfy Lord Vishnu. Always remember Vishnu, never forget him. That is his only goal. Let me serve in anywhere. I may be in a hellish planet, but if I have an opportunity to serve the Supreme Lord, then I like that place. That is the philosophy of Vaishnavism. This is just described in this episode of Vrutrasura, Maharaja Chitraketu, how when he became a Vrutrasura. He very happily accepted the curse of Parvati Devi. And he proved that he don't fear, a devotee never fearful in any situation. His only concern is to how to serve the Lord. Srila Prabhupada went to New York City. That is, comparing to, he was very peaceful in Radha Damodar chanting in the rounds, and he could return back to Godhead from here. Why he went to New York City and Bower the 26th Avenue, where he opened the center there, and he suffered so much with the hippies in the beginning days. But still, because of compassion and because of following the spiritual master orders to satisfy the Supreme Lord. But that is a devotee. Devotee don't worry, all these things. In London one time Prabhupada was giving lecture and someone asked, what is Prabhupada, what is hell is planet, what is the definition of hell? So Prabhupada told, this London is hell. London is hell, this is hell. Where not properly the sunshine is, just sunshine not showering everywhere. And people are like, and living like animals, illicit sex, gambling, meat eating, and intoxication. So that is hellish planet. So that's why devotee not fearful, all these things. That is this episode Vrutrasura is proving. Though he is in a demoniac species, but he is better than any demigod. Even Indra was confused. Who is this personality? Okay. Hare Krishna. Granthras Madhvagavatam ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.